Well, where do we start? Well, yesterday we were in
Nashville,
and we're just leaving there now, and you may recognise some different things in this car. That's because it's a different car. We had to go to Alamo this morning and change over, so we have a Trailblazer again, nice white one, because the cigarette light packed up in the Durango, and so therefore we had no satellite navigation, mobile phone, because that couldn't be charged, no iPod, it was disastrous, so we were getting lost. Well, actually, yes, we left Memphis yesterday and were due to go to Memphis Airport to change the car over, and then suddenly found ourselves on our way to Nashville, about 60 miles gone past Memphis, so we couldn't even find the airport.
We were planning to go to Nashville anyway, so.
We were, actually.
Came straight here.
Indeed. It is pissing down with rain today.
Freeway entrance on the right.
So we've got the car.
I-24.
Shut up. We're getting out of Nashville now and we're heading to Louisville in Kentucky, where baseball obviously is quite a big thing. Babe Ruth and also the
Fort Knox
is there as well. And the Kentucky Derby is there every May, so it's quite a few places for us to see there. So that's where we're heading and should be there in a couple of hours.
Yeah, so hopefully a little bit more at the show than yesterday, because there was nothing. It was pouring rain. We just went out for
a meal
and a drink in the hotel, which was really nice, by the way.
The Hilton, yeah, right on in
Nashville. But nothing to show, which was a real shame.
We could have gone to the Country and Western Museum singing, but as we don't really give a shit about country and Western music, we decided not to pay the $16 each entry fee and decided to get out there. So, we'll be back to you later with an update.
Oh, well, we've just rushed to get to the.
Hi, I'm Rich.
Okay, thanks, Lorna. The baseball museum that we just found out we've lost another hour, and it closes in 20 minutes. But a man was nice enough to just let me quickly come in at no charge, have a quick look round. So we're going to blast around. We might come back tomorrow if we've got time, but if not, just to give you something to look at. But oh dear. Commentator.
Ounces of white ash, just about ready for the ball field. It looks like that first bet we made for Pete Browning a few years back. It's prime timber, you can be sure of that. Take these pieces over here. We call them bilts when they're shaped like that. I'm told that's a French word which means the trunk of a tree. And here are what you could call the blueprints for the bats. Actually, they're specification cards, and we use them to record the length, weight, and shape of the various models of bats we produce. As we start to make a bat, we use a roughing tool, which is sort of a cross between a knife and a gouge. We use it for the heavier cutting. It's the one with the black handle. Then we shape the handle of the bat with a tool that looks a lot like a hook. It's called a knob tool. I have to say, getting the right shape to the knob is probably the trickiest part in the whole process. The finishing tool is used for the final stage. That's the one on the right. It looks a lot like a roughing tool, only it's lighter for more precise shaping. And you can be sure that every step of the way we're referring to the specification card and checking measurements with a caliper. We use 7 different tools in all to get each bat just right.
Oh my God, look, that is Babe Ruth's bat. It was discovered, oh my God, tucked away in an attic. He used that to do his last home run as a New York Yankee. Baby. Well, I've just quickly snuck out of the museum to show you the factory here, where all of the wood is piled up, ready to be made into baseball bats. This is where they make them, at the Slugger factory, but we were too late to get on the tour because we didn't realise there was a bloody time difference. So we now lost another hour. The museum shut in 20 bloody minutes. give you an idea. You can see all of the wood ready to be made. Cool.
Okay, we stopped off at the Louisville Slugger Bat Company, which is the producer of some of the famous bats used by baseball players. And that, actually or not, is a real wooden baseball bat. The biggest one in the world, apparently. And we've lost an hour. We only had 15 minutes in there, so that's it.